that breathes, sing. You're the one, you're the one who makes mountains move. Stars will not shine unless you tell them to, tell them to. Conquered the grave to make all things anew. So who am I?
Dear fall colors, check out Toyota's crisp, bold lineup. There's the rugged Tacoma, the spacious Highlander, and 4Runners and off-road icon. Color me impressed. Toyota. Visit Toyota.com to learn more. Toyota, let's go places.
I've been thinking about time and where does it go? How can I stop my life from passing me by? I don't know. I've been thinking about family, now it's going so fast. Will I wake up one morning just wishing that I could go back? I've been thinking about lately, maybe I can make a change and let it change me. So with all of my heart, this is my prayer. Singing, oh, Lord, keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes wide open. Cause I don't wanna miss what you have for me. Singing, oh, Lord, show me what matters. Throw away what I'm chasing after. Cause I don't wanna miss what you have for me. Touch my heart, don't let me stray, I just wanna stay where you are. All I got is one shot, one try, one go around in this beautiful life. Nothing is wasted when everything's placed in your hands. Singing, oh, Lord, keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes wide open. What you have for me? Singing, oh, Lord, show me what matters. Throw away what I'm chasing after. I don't wanna miss what you have for me. And the promise you hold. So it's all eyes on you until the day you call me home. Singing, oh, Lord, keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes wide open. Cause I don't wanna miss what you have for me.
Tutu. give a life, you are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, we pour out our praise to you, only you. Great are you, Lord. You give a life.
My enemies till all
years are gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child. From my mother's womb, you have chosen me. Love has called my name. I've been born again into your family. Your blood flows through my veins. I'm no longer a slave. Fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. Child of God, I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I am a child of God.
So the last time that the time before, I guess, that I recorded something to send this way when I was in Germany. I don't know if I said anything about this story or not. Probably not, because it was a morning worship thing. But I'm trying to think if it was the day. I can't remember. I think it was a couple days before that I recorded the thing with the flowers behind me and stuff, whatever. But I was in Bremen, Germany. And I wanted to play on the street that day. I wanted to go busking because I had a day off, and I don't do days off. I'm not about it. I'm going to play somewhere. And so I'm like, I'm going to play on the street. It's going to be so cool. And so I'm driving through, and I drive over this river area, and I look, and I see hundreds of people along the river. I'm like, that's where I'm going. That makes sense. Go play music in front of a bunch of people so that maybe somebody cares or whatever. And I find my way there. Parking was miserable because there's a big an orchestra that was happening that night at one of these huge, beautiful churches. And so parking was crazy. And so I eventually parked a long, long, long ways away. I did find the river. And I went and I parked. It cost me so much money to park. And I took my backpack. I took my little tripod and my guitar, and I took off walking. And I get to this space where all these people are, and I realize this is a flea market. Like, I mean, these people are trying to sell stuff and earn money. These people are trying to buy super discounted stuff because they're broke. I'm like, I'm in the wrong spot, right? So I'm like, but there's people, and, you know, God can do anything. And so I go, and there's this, like, a kiosk. It's like a pub slash, it said espresso. I'm like, I'm going to get an espresso and ask them if I can play outside their pub because people are walking up there constantly. And so I go, and There's people in line there. So I walk down this little hallway. It's like the only covered spot that wasn't in the sun, right? But there are these guys from, I don't know where they're from, but guy had a flute that had tape on it and stuff. A guy with an acoustic guitar and then a full drum kit that was just destroyed. But he had a full drum kit in this concrete tunnel thing. So I'm like, this isn't going to work. I can't play here. And they spoke zero English. So they didn't communicate with me at all. I was like, all right, see ya. So I go back and I said, is there any way? I was like, one, could I get an espresso? I was like, yeah, that'd be great. Could I play some songs out here? I was like, please, because all I've been able to hear for an hour is that, right? Is what she pointed down that hallway. I'm like, okay. And she knows nothing about me. She doesn't even know if I can play anything, right? It's like, please, yes. And so I went to this little open spot. There's a bench. I set my camera up and I put it on time lapse. Cause I'm like, if something cool happens, it'd be great to have a document of it. And I opened my guitar case in hopes of making some sort of money as a street performer. And so I'm playing. I played for an hour in the sun, right? There's a few people that like kept standing there and like watching and like applauding or whatever, but they never once walked up and dropped any money in the box, right? So I'm like, okay. All these people walking by and they give thumbs up or they'd smile. Some people came over and like they dropped stuff in, but I wasn't paying attention to how much. It's just if they were. So after an hour, I'm like, I'm burning alive. Like I'm literally that espresso didn't do the trick with my thirst. And there's like, I hear a commotion and I turn and look and there's two different groups of people and they're all dressed in like white outfits type thing. And there's someone in front of each group pushing a cart. And I realize that's a beer cart that has a big speaker in the front of it. Like I hear, and they're like just walking and like they look ridiculous, right? And they get up there and they literally, they're from here to the back of the room from me. It's like, they're drinking all this stuff. I'm like, I have to get out of here. This is pointless, right? So I counted when I was putting my guitar in there, it was €8 for an hour of playing in the sun. I'm like, no way, right? And so I go and I'm walking back towards the car and I see this like a pizza place here and there's another pub. I notice they have a stage inside. You can see the stage. So I'm like, maybe I could see about playing here. But the best part is like there are these huge trees. So there was shade and there was a sitting area. People were eating food. And I'm like, this is the spot. And so I walk up to the guy. He's standing at the bar. I'm like, hey, would it be okay if I play some songs? He's like, right now? I'm like, yeah. He's like, inside or out? I'm like, what in the world? This is too easy, right? And he was like, you can play here on the stage or you can play in the front, just wherever you want. I'm like, okay. And he's like, but it's not time for the rush yet. They're all at the river, which is where I just came from. But I guess they were like a half a mile further down the river where everyone does like stand-up paddleboard and stuff. And so I sit in this chair in the shade, and I'm so thankful I'm in the shade, right? And I start playing songs, and I get to this point of where I see like this group of like 9 or 10 guys walking up. One of them's pulling a wagon, like a little wagon with little side rails on it. And they walk up and they stand right by the street over in this area, and they're just like standing there and they're drinking. There's people sitting around here. People stop and they'll sit for half a song and they'll leave and like maybe drop, you know, a euro in my case or whatever. But the guy running the pub is so, he seems stoked. Like he's just happy that there's something going on. And so I get to this one point of where I'm like, I start playing this song. It's like, they'll know this song, you know. I was like, Tommy used to work on a dock, right? And I get to this point of where I'm about to, I was like, say we got a hold on to what we got. Doesn't make a difference if we make it or not. We got each other, and that's a lot. And this guy's walking up towards me, and he stands about 3 feet from me. And I was like, I was about to go, we'll give it a shot. And he's standing there. I'm like, hey, I stopped playing. He's like, do you know the song Wonderwall? I'm like, what's that? He's like, Wonderwall. I'm like, Wonderwall? Like by Oasis? Yes. Do you know it? I'm like, I know what the song is. I've never played it. He's like, could you play it? I'm like, I haven't heard that song in 20 years type thing. And this guy doesn't care because he's being persistent. And he moves over to here now. And he's like, it's my friends. This is his bachelor party. And so we're doing a German tradition, which is basically walk all around Germany, pulling a wagon with your friends and getting hammered and eating pretzels. And I'm like, what? He's like, yes, it's a tradition. I'm like, okay. He's like, could we video you playing the song and dedicate? I'm like, I don't know it. He's like, today's gonna, I'm like, today. He's like, yes, okay. I played one chord, right? And he comes over, and they already gave a phone to these two guys trying to eat pizza, whatever. And the guy's like, what? And he's like, he turns around, and these guys make a half moon shape in front of me, right? So anybody else that was listening, they're just looking at the backs of these guys' heads, right? And so he's like, okay, we're ready. I was like, today is gonna be the day that they're gonna throw it back to you. By now, you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. I said, I don't know the rest. He's like, okay, keep going. I'm like, I don't know it. Backbeat, the wood is on the street, and the life in your heart is out. I know you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. He said, okay. I said, maybe. He's like, yeah, this is so great. I'm like, that was a train wreck. I had no clue. I had never played it. I was literally like, all right, Jesus, make a moment somehow. I was like, that was right. I was like, gonna be the one that, okay, that, okay. It was a miracle. Like when it comes to like, wow, that shouldn't have happened because I did not know that song. And one of the guys throws 20 euro in my case. I'm like, that was so worth that. I sat in the sun for an hour. I played 15 songs. Like, and there was a couple people that's like, it's so great. Thank you so much. At the river. But like, it was crazy because at the end of that time frame that I played, and those guys stood there, they just kept standing there drinking, doing their tradition, I guess. And people were coming and going and all this stuff. And by the time that I was like, you know what, I'm gonna play one more song is what I was like. And I did. I ended the song with this. And I was the whole time, I'm like, God, you're so cool because these people are still here. They're still sitting here. And those guys are still standing there. And so I did. I was like, the weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. 'Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. My God will never fail. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord.
Enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil, and you turn it for good. Turn it for good. You take what the enemy meant for evil. See a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory, for the battle belongs to you, Lord.
So I just saw it as like, you know what, there's an audience, there's someone here, there's, if there was one person, I mean, because I've done it 500 times, like, it doesn't matter how many people in a room, I believe that whoever is there is supposed to be there. And the cool thing is about technology now, and one thing that we all learned about COVID is like, it doesn't matter if someone is tuned in at that moment to see whatever's going on or to listen to whatever's going on, they can always search for it and it will randomly pop up, you know, due to algorithm, whatever, makes no sense to me. But I know that I still seek out like Billy Graham sermons that are very old, you know, I'll seek them out and I'll check them out. And it's still so relevant because it's the gospel. That's it. It's always going to be relevant. It's always going to be like, man, that I really, when people's like, that really spoke to me where I was, like where I'm at right now. I'm like, that's what it has always done. And it always will. And so with that situation, I'm like, why would I waste an opportunity to play a song that talks about victory, you know, and about it's because of God that there's a victory. And you have these guys, like they just want to hear music. It's just what you choose to play while they're listening was so, so cool. And then all these people over here that they weren't even in my line of sight, but they're sitting there eating food from this restaurant and they didn't leave. They didn't get up and walk off. And so at the end of that, that time frame, that day, when I totaled up all of my euro that I had made throughout a very long time, I had made 38 euro that day. And I was like, yes. I'm like, that's good. I mean, that's like $44, you know? And so, because it was a day off before. It was a day off. I was going to just be killing time trying to figure out when I could call my wife again without bugging her to death. Like it's like, hey, I know you're bored, but we got stuff going here. I got school to teach. I get it. But that day turned out so cool. And if I had stuck with staying at that one spot and kind of being, I was kind of bummed out that I played for so long and it was 8 euro. But at the same time, I'm like, that could buy me McDonald's later. And this was a day off. And so I'm like, then I go up to a different spot, kind of just moved a bit, changed position. And it made it so worthwhile because of those guys. If they hadn't dropped any money in there, they stayed. And I'm like, that is so crazy. Because of Wonderwall, they wanted to hear Wonderwall. And they heard a whole lot more than that, you know? So I think it's so cool. I think it's so cool what God does, what he can do. Whether it's one person or a room full of people, he's the same, and that's cool. Because I learned on my first tour ever when I was 19 years old to never let the amount of people dictate your attitude. It's like you get out there and you perform. Because whoever is there, when they leave, they're going to be talking about the show they went to. I went to see Spoken. And whether or not it's like, oh, cool, or who's that? They're going to be like, yeah, they looked bored. They looked like they'd rather be somewhere else. And I promise you, no one can say that about our band because we have gone all out for 5 people 100 times, probably more than that. And what do they leave? They leave saying, I was glad that it was a small show because I got to hang out with the guys forever. And for the band, that doesn't feel great while it's happening when you're up there like screaming your brains out. But afterwards, you're like, that was so cool because we got to talk to those whoever, how many people for that long. And they can say, those guys went bonkers for the 5 of us. It was so cool. Like the thing is, like, it wasn't those 5 people's fault that there wasn't 500 people there. So I just want to play, you know? I have so much to learn. I'm confused by the moments. I forget the words that it takes to remember the depths of your love and the strength in your mercy. The only thing I know is I belong to you. I belong to you. I belong to you. Jesus, you are more than the words I have written on this page, more than the melody singing your praise, surrendering heartache and all of my mistakes. The only thing that's true is I belong to you. I belong to you, I belong to you, Jesus. Yeah.
reflection of you and ever me. You have set me free. Oh, I never knew how much I needed you. But you've opened my eyes and touched my heart. Show me who you are. You are forever. Inside you, I walked a million miles in these shoes. I walked a million more after you, so I can live safe inside your arms. You are forever. You are the one. Light in the darkness, you are the sun. Oh God, you are the keeper of my heart. You are forever, you are the one. Light in the darkness, you are the sun. Oh God, you are the keeper of my heart.
I know you guys know that one. You've heard it a few times. I got a video of someone playing it. It's pretty cool. You play it all the time? FaceTimed him one night. I was in Chanute, Kansas, and I was standing there. I was about to play, but I remembered, like, man, I didn't send those chords. I'm like, it's funny. I enjoy talking to him. I think he's funny. I talked to him the other night a bit when he was in Santa Fe, and he ordered chicken wings, bone-in chicken wings. I'm like, why'd you do that? He said, well, I don't have the sauce on them. I got the sauce on the side. You're still getting chicken. If he's listening to this, you're still getting chicken grease all over your hands. I mean, still the same thing. It's still got a bone in it. Everyone in this room is probably bone-in wing people. I'm like, yeah, I knew it. No way. I can't do it. I can't. Yeah, it's just different. It's just different. It's nuggets. But I was curious. I always kind of give the disclaimer that this could be a mistake, especially if there's teenagers in the room when I ask it, but Are there any questions that you guys might have that you've wondered and I've never answered it, like just offered it up or whatever, but are there any questions that you've just been curious about? Here we go. Yeah, what's your question? Cut them off? Well, that's, you have to figure out like how much nylon is in your shoelaces, because if you do cut them off, you need to like light them and sear it so they don't fray, because they'll just take off fraying if you go cutting them off. It's the right answer. That's true. Any other questions? Well, tomorrow in the morning I'm playing at a Christian school that I booked it today. No, tomorrow in Phoenix, in Chandler. So in the morning, and then, I don't live in Phoenix. I live in Iowa. I live in Des Moines. If I'm in town or I scheduled in town, I'll play on the worship team or play a song or maybe fill a spot if it needs filled. But I'm not on staff or anything. I'm gone too much. People wouldn't want me to be. JR, yeah, he plays in Phoenix and Glendale and like kind of all over. I think there's 5 campuses down there that he kind of bounces around, plays at. Yeah, question and. That's awesome. When do I get it? Do I get it now? Yeah. Okay, I'm going to put it right here. Thank you. No. Thank you very much. That's almost like one of my t-shirt designs. It's got arrows on it. Thank you. I don't play Phoenix a lot. I wish I could. I'd really like to play there more, but I did do a bunch of throw together stuff because I'm playing in Maricopa on Tuesday and tomorrow was a day off. And so I'm playing at a coffee shop, Cultivate Coffee in Phoenix tomorrow from 2 to 4. But I'm also doing, they don't have chapel in the morning. They have chapel on Tuesday. And so I'm going to play tomorrow morning just for the kids are there. It's not a chapel thing, but I'm going back to this Christian school on Tuesday morning to play chapel service. And then I play Maricopa Tuesday night. And then, I'll play a private event in Camp Verde on Wednesday. And then I'll drive all night and all day to like Northwest Kansas where I play on Thursday night. And then I'll drive home from there to Des Moines. So days off, I'm just kind of like, if I can feel useful, I guess, you know, I could feel like I'm doing something musically and whoever God wants to bring into my path during that, that's cool. I mean, that coffee shop thing tomorrow, it's just like, I want to be available. I want to make myself available. And they had nothing going on other than just serving coffee. And they said that that the high schoolers get out at 2:45, so they would be coming through to get coffee. And so I'm like, all right, so between 2 and 4 would be a good time frame to at least have the opportunity to play some songs for high schoolers. They're like, yep. I'm like, done. Let's do it. So, and the Christian school, it's a new school. Like it's brand new. It's pretty small, but they meet at a church in the Chandler area. And one of the teachers normally does chapel. So I'm like, I'll do it. And they're like, that would be cool. So that's what I'll do tomorrow morning and Tuesday morning. Yes. Question? I would say a lot of it has to do with they actually have chapel services. They teach Bible. I mean, that would be the major difference, I think, that they teach you Bible and about Jesus in school. I'd say that'd be the major difference. It's a good question, though. All right. Anything else? You have a question? Sorry. It's going to be a ridiculous answer, so I don't know. How long are the eyelashes? It's probably an obvious answer. Oh, I have no idea. I thought that was like some kind of, you know, like, this will be funny. Watch this. I don't know. I don't know the answer to that. This is a spoken song, if that's okay. Is that okay? You're like, whatever.
Ago, a future was laid before me, and I took the task and ran with it as far as I could go. I always wanted to be a part of something like this. You are here with me, and it's all I needed. Know that I'm loving you, that I love you.
September, we begin it all.
Before I go, please know that I love you with all of my heart.
So there are times, I'll cut you right off. You don't have to do that. There are times where you're starting to do something, and you can apply this to any part of your life. Like anything that this relates to you, it will apply, and you'll probably think of more than one instance where this has happened. But this morning, there was like a miscommunication because there wasn't a text thread of this morning, right? It was a phone call, which is weird, right? For some people, like, to talk on the phone, like, it's like, okay, it's rare to book a show, whether it be a spoken show, an acoustic show, a morning worship situation. It's rare to book it like on the phone. Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, put it on the calendar, right? But that's what I did with Pastor Dave. Like, I remember talking to him. He was on his way into the courthouse because he's also a judge, a pastor, a bunch of stuff. So he was on his way in the courthouse, and it was a busy day for him. I was driving as well. And I'm like, yeah, cool, that date works. I'm like, okay, yep, let's plan on it, right? So I put it in my phone immediately because I once something confirms, it's in my phone, and hopefully it doesn't get messed up, right? Anyway, that was the last we had talked about it. I had messaged him about some like sound gear that I was selling this week, and he's like, "Nah, I'm good. We've got everything we need, whatever. But I'll pass the info to some other people, whatever." And so I walk up this morning onto the front like porch area of the church, and I hear music. I hear the worship band like playing. I'm like, you know that thing where you're like, something's not what I think it is right now. Something's not quite what I thought was happening. And Dave's wife walks out. It's like, Matt Baird, what's going on? What are you doing here? And I'm like, oh no. What have I done? Like, I'm here on the wrong day. But I'm like, maybe not. Maybe they're rehearsing for something else. And so, and she's like, so what's going on? What are you doing? Passing through? I'm like, no, I haven't my phone that I'm supposed to be here this morning. He's like, really? And she's like, maybe Dave forgot. I'm like, I what do you say to that? Like, I don't know. Anyway, I walk in, and he's up there, and they're playing a song, and I can see the gears turning. Like, what's going on right now? Like, but he finished the whole song, and he comes up. He's like, hey, what's going on? I'm like, I had it in my phone. I was here. He's like, and he's like looking through his text or whatever. I'm like, we talked on the phone. And you're on your way into court, all of a sudden. He's like, that's right. That's right. Yeah, I didn't put it on the calendar. And so then I'm like, I'm going through all these scenarios in my mind. I'm like, who am I going to agitate by being here today? Like, I'm a little ways from home. I want to be here. And it was so awesome. He's like, no, that's great. One of our worship guys is out of town, and that means I have to do it. He's like, this is great. And so I'm like, okay. I was like, how much does this mess up stuff? He's like, not at all. Like, no, this is great. He's like, I remember the conversation. I just didn't tell anybody else about it. And so I'm like, well, I mean, but everyone's already prepared. Like, he's like, it's fine. They'll play next week. And I'm like, all right. He's like, I'm still going to preach though. I'm like, no, that's amazing. I've never got to hear you preach. And so this morning I was a bit frazzled when the first service started. Okay. There's two services. And I was standing up there, and I was trying to like, I was like, I want to play this certain song, but like, I'm like, how do I, what, I was like, what in the world? I was trying to figure out, that's why it didn't make sense. So it's supposed to be, That's what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to be like,
can't go back to the beginning.
Right? That's what it's supposed to be. But I started here. I'm like,
can't go back
to. It's like, that's, as here, it's like, that's not, it's like,
can't go back to the.
It was so off, right? I'm like, and so I kept playing it, thinking it was going to work out, but I started vocally in the wrong key. So when I got here, it's like, it's supposed to be,
not enough unless you come. Will you meet me here again?
When I got here, it's like,
it's not enough.
I was so off. I'm like, Jesus, help me. What? And I felt all this crazy adrenaline, like going bonkers, because I'm like, I don't know how to correct this. I don't know how to correct this path I'm going down. I don't know the next step, right? And I'm talking chords and vocal melody, okay? I had to stop. I had to stop playing, and I muttered something. I was like, wow, I was a bit frazzled. That was really bad. And so I was like,
there's nothing worth more.
I had to go back to a familiar place. I had to go back to what was more common for me and get my bearings. I had to go back and I had to start over. And it was so crazy because God used me slaughtering a song. Like, I mean, it wrecked me mentally in my heart. I'm like, oh, this is awful. Because I don't like doing that. I don't like feeling that way. And I'm like, I'm going to be on one of those worship fails compilations. Like, you got some guy slaughtering a well-known, you don't know what that is? Worship fails? Oh, wow. I'm like, and so God was able to at least convince me in my mind, we're tying this in to today. We're tying this into the service. We're tying this in to relating to every person that's in this room, because everyone has felt that way. Of just like, kind of, you're spinning out of control. You're not sure how to right the ship. And a lot of times people don't just stop, take a breath, and start again. They just keep down that path, that trail that's just, oh, utter chaos. And so I didn't like the way I felt at all. I was uneasy. It wasn't familiar territory for me. And maybe there are people this morning that needed to hear that, of like, you need to start over. Start at A, then move on to B, C, whatever. And that starting at A is Jesus. It's starting there, because that's the true north. That's what our goal is. And so it's like, ugh, why would I have to be the example this morning of like, wow, talk about a train derailment. You're staring at one, you know? I already know that about myself. but luckily, the rest of that set was fine, and I definitely didn't play that song. Like, the whole thing is like, right, it took me figuring out now.
Can't go back to the beginning.
I started on the wrong chord from the beginning. A lot of us, we start off on the wrong foot, and then it's when we have destroyed everything, and we get to this point where we're like, man, I've tried everything else. My last resort's to talk to God about it. Where it's like, actually, each of us, we probably should realize the first step is, all right, Jesus, I have no clue what I'm doing. Please help me. And I'm like, took me all day to figure out I started the wrong chord. All day. I'm like, what did I do? Why did that not sound right? And the reason it didn't sound right or feel right is because it wasn't right. And again, there's another parallel. We're in a situation, we feel uneasy in a relationship because it's not right. Feel uneasy in our job, like, because it's not right. That song sucks because it's not right, you know? It's like, there's a lot going on up here right now, I guess. Like, what in the world?
You must think I'm strong. Looks like more than I can do. reaching out. Who gives me strength, and I don't have to be strong enough. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength, and I don't have to be strong enough.
It's a good reminder. We're not strong enough. We're not supposed to be. That's why it's important for us to be desperate for our Creator. A lot of crazy stuff goes on. A lot of things, a lot of chapters in our life that we don't understand, a lot of situations, a lot of frustrations. And I do wish that each of us would realize quicker that we're not supposed to do it on our own. And I think it's so crazy that, I mean, I know of three people in this room who have dealt with vision situations and kind of unexplainable, like, what is going on? I mean, when they told me that, they're like, you either have had a stroke or you have a blood clot in your brain. Like, to hear that come out of a doctor's mouth, you're like, wait, what? And I heard that when I was in Cincinnati, Ohio on tour. And I'll back up a little bit. Yes, that's frustrating. That's frustrating to hear that. But the night before, we were playing this show, and we were on tour with a non-Christian band, and I'd been like talking to the vocalist here and there or whatever, and this guy had been in and out of like drug rehab off and on for 20 years, right? And I'm working on our van, because the air doesn't work in their back, so it's just blowing hot air. And we had been in Florida burning alive to death, right? And I'm like, I got to figure this out. So I have the back seat gone. I had to rip out the bench that we had built for someone to sleep on, you know, like this bunk. Ripped it out. I had to rip the corner panel off the inside, and I'm trying to figure this out. I'm burning up. And this guy walks up, his name is Seth. He's like, hey, you want to get that cup of coffee now? I'm like, yep, I do. I had stuff to do. I needed to figure that out, but I'm like, I don't even care right now. The fact that he made that step of like, let's go hang out, have coffee. So we walk down the road, we go to this coffee shop, and this conversation ends up talking, one, yes, about my favorite skateboarder of all time, Christian Hosoi. And he's like, oh, that's crazy. I actually ended up at a church that he's like associate pastor at. I'm like, totally, that's crazy. This guy doesn't know Jesus, okay? We end up talking about the grace of Jesus and about forgiveness and about, it was so awesome. And he gets a call. We're in the middle of this conversation. He gets calls like, hey, doors are opening. And he's like, oh, we got to go. And so I'm like, totally. I'm like, wow, that was bad timing for doors to open. And so we go back, we play, they play. I'm back out there working on the van that night, and they're leaving the parking lot, and he's like, hey, Matt. I'm like, yeah. He's like, let's finish that conversation tomorrow. I'm like, absolutely, yes. I'm like, this is so cool that this person wants to talk about Jesus. this person who does not believe in Jesus wants to talk. I'm like, this is so cool. This is why we're on this tour. That's why we're on this tour. And so we take off driving. We drive quite a ways, pull over to Walmart to sleep for a few hours. And I wake up and I'm seeing triple. I'm like, what in the world? Like, my glasses don't matter. Like, I'm seeing triple. But I realized that if I closed one eye, I could see enough to drive. And so I drive towards Cincinnati. I don't wake my guys up because I don't want them to freak out. But I'm driving, and I tell Tiffany, I'm like, hey, here's what's going on. She's like, you have to go to the hospital. You have to figure out what. And so I went, and I ended up going to this clinic that was attached to a church, right? I'm like, this will be the place to go. But it turns out the churches, they're no longer like working together because they split ways, but it's still in this same building attached to this big church. I'm like, ugh. I walk in, I've got my right eye closed, and this lady's like, hey, what's going on? I'm like, hey, I need to see about getting checked out. I don't know what's going on. They're like, are you a patient? I'm like, I'm not. It's like, well, you need to go to the university hospital then, because we're not taking new patients. And so I've still got my eye closed, and she's like, I'm sorry, but you know, you need to go and blah, blah, blah. I was like, okay. And this lady walks through the doors, and she's like, hey, she's like, what's going on? What's going on with your eye? I'm like, I'm seeing triple. She's like, hold on. And she goes back and she comes right out. She's like, the doctor will see you right now. And so I go in there, I sit down, this guy's checking me out, doing all the stuff that we were talking about. And he's like, I don't want to alarm you. I don't, but either you have had a stroke or you have a blood clot in your brain. You need to be at a neurologist like yesterday. I'm like, what? He's like, you need to go to a specialist. And I'm like, okay. And so I walk out, and my first thought was like, Jesus, I trust you. I don't know what's going on, but I hope it's not what he just said. I trust you. I don't like the timing. I was like, I'm supposed to talk to Seth tonight. I'm supposed to talk to Seth tonight about you. And I'm like, I got to figure out what to tell Tiffany. And so I lean up against the wall outside the church, or well, the building, whatever it was. I'm like, Jesus, please, I know you're in control. Whatever you are doing, I trust you. So I called Tiffany. I told her, she's like, come home. Cancel the tour. Have one of the guys drive you home. Come home now. I'm like, okay. So I tell the guys what's going on, because they went to Chick-fil-A that was also in the church parking lot while I go to get checked out of what's wrong with me. And I go over, I'm like, we've got to go home. Here's what's going on. They're like, what? So I contacted management. I was like, here's what's going on. I got to cancel. The first person of anybody other than who I just told that called me was Seth. He calls like, hey man, you all right? I'm like, I don't know, man. He's like, hey, go home. Don't worry about anything. We'll get everything taken care of. We'll talk soon. I'm like, all right. I haven't heard from him since. I haven't heard from him at all. I haven't been able to get a hold of him. Nothing. I'm like so frustrated that anything to do with vision happened and I had to cancel the rest of the tour. And here we're years later. This is years later. This is before COVID. And I'm still frustrated that I didn't get to keep talking to him. And you know what? The thing is, like, I could have talked to him for days, and if the Holy Spirit wasn't doing something in that moment, it wouldn't have mattered. That was facts, you know? And they told me at the neurologist, like, you got migraines. I'm like, it's not migraines. I've had migraines my whole life. And he's like, yeah, it's something. It's whatever. But it took a guy at Wolf Eye Clinic about 20 seconds to be like, oh, this is a vision thing. Like, yeah, we got it figured out. It's a decompensated fornea, and we're going to put a prism on your glasses, and you'll be all set. It's what he did. He put a sticker on my glasses, and it corrected it. I'm a train wreck without my glasses on, but sometimes we need a prism in our line of sight. Sometimes we need something to slow us down, to make us see what's actually in front of us. I didn't need to talk to Seth anymore. We'd already talked. I was like, I believe in Jesus, that he's Son of God, Savior of this world. That's what I believe. That's all I needed to say. But it's hard, because vision is something like, we want to see it to understand it. We want to see it in front of us. Sometimes we don't get to do that. But I'm absolutely grateful that I was able to be on that tour. I was grateful I was able to talk about Jesus, that God allowed me to do it. I'm grateful that you guys said, yeah, come on, cool, let's do something that sounds fun for tonight. Like, I'm very thankful. I'm very thankful that you guys, you support me in so many ways. Like, it's crazy. And God has put you in my life. I'm going to play one more and then hang out a bit and go to Phoenix and go play for some kids in the morning that have no clue I'm coming. They have no idea that I'm coming. And I hope that those high school kids at the coffee shop actually do come tomorrow. It's not like, oh, I don't want coffee today. They'll come. Thanks again for everything. All my words fall short. I've got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do. Every song must end. Throw up my head, praise you again and again. All that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not mine, nothing else fits. Thank you.
days you were getting down again. All that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much.
Thank you so much for all you've given us. We thank you for the opportunity to come and to sing songs to you and about you, about your love for us. We give our lives to you. Help us to go back to the start, start anew. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Thank you, guys.